Two-factor authentication. Accessing ERA modules via login.gov. What to do when you want to switch to a different login.gov account? Welcome to this video tutorial that will demonstrate what to do if you switch your login.gov account that you use to authenticate to an ERA module. We will use ERA Commons as an example. Before you begin the process of associating your ERA Commons account with a different login.gov account, it is important to be sure your ERA Commons password is current and valid. If you have forgotten your password, or it has expired, you can use the Forgot Password, Unlock Account link on the ERA Commons login page to reset your password. Or contact your ERA signing official for assistance with resetting your password. For any number of reasons, you may have an additional login.gov account, and you may wish to use this other account to authenticate to ERA Commons. ERA permits you to update this association, giving you additional flexibility when accessing ERA modules. Once you have confirmed your ERA Commons credentials are valid, you will go to the ERA Commons login page and select the login.gov option. Click Continue on the confirmation dialog window and enter your alternative login.gov credentials, email and password, and the additional authentication method you set up with that login.gov account. You will be presented with the Associate Your ERA Account screen. To create the new association, you will need to enter your ERA Commons credentials, your user ID and password. After entering your credentials, click Continue. ERA will check these credentials and find that an association between Commons and login.gov already exists for your ERA Commons account. You will then be presented with a change mapping screen. This screen lets you know that another login.gov account is associated with your Commons account. If you wish to update the association to the new login.gov account, you will need to provide your ERA Commons password again, and then click Continue. If you do not wish to update the association, click Cancel. If you continue, you will be brought to ERA Commons. From this point forward, you can use the new login.gov account when you click on the login.gov option on the ERA Commons homepage. Authenticate with your login.gov credentials and the additional authentication method you set up with that account. If you do not want to enter a code every time, click the box that states, "Remember this browser." If you use the same browser and computer to log into ERA Commons, login.gov will remember these settings and not require you to enter the two-factor authentication source each time you log in, and you will go directly to ERA Commons. Do not go directly to login.gov and attempt to access an ERA module from there. That will get you to your login.gov account settings page. This is helpful if you wish to change your login.gov password or add additional authentication methods. A second authentication option can be used if your first or primary authentication method is not available. For example, if you don't have your cell phone with you to receive the authentication code text message, you can select a different authentication method that you have set up. There are a variety of resources available to you should you need help with managing your login.gov account and associating it with your ERA Commons account. If you are still having issues with login.gov to authenticate to ERA Commons, visit the login.gov contact page. For issues related to your ERA account or to associating your login.gov account with your ERA account, contact the ERA service desk. This concludes this tutorial on demonstrating what to do if you switch your login.gov account that you use to authenticate to an ERA module. Thank you for watching.